How to set a custom white balance. Custom white balance is very important because we don't always know the color of our lights. It's called white balance because we want the whites to come out white and not a color that has a tint like a pink. Some of the sources are bulbs like this. This is a fluorescent bulb, but it's not made for photography. It's made to put in your household lamps at home and illuminate your space. We don't know what the color of this is, so we would need to do a custom white balance to get the most accurate color. This bulb is made for photography. It's an incandescent bulb. The problem is as these get older, they get redder. So we do a custom white balance for this to make sure we've got the color right for the bulb as it is right now. To do that, we need to measure a source that's either white or gray. This is an old piece of mat board, and it looks white to us, but it may not be. It's not something that's a known light source. And this one is. This is a white that's made for photography, and this is a gray that's made for photography. I tend to like to use the gray card when I'm doing this myself. Now, everybody's camera is different. My camera will measure a custom white balance one way, yours will another way. You have to look at your instructions to see how to do it for your camera. The most important two things are this, that you have your gray card in the light that you're going to be using for your photograph. I'm going to use these two incandescent lights that are set up here and turned on for this one. So I have to have that gray card in that illumination. Second, when I do the measurement for the custom white balance, I have to have only the gray card visible in my viewfinder. The first thing you need to do for my camera is to meter the gray card. I've done that, and I'm ready to go as far as that's concerned. It doesn't matter if the gray card is in focus. Again, it has to fill the frame. And when you do that, it should look just like this. Once I know that I have only the gray card in there, there's something else that's important too. I have to have my other lights off in the room that I'm not going to be using because I only want these incandescent lights to illuminate my subjects. So could you turn the lights off, please? Now the gray card is in the light I'm going to be using, and I need to do a couple of things. I need to first take a meter reading off of the gray card. I've done that already, so I'm ready to go. On my camera, I select something called preset. When I do that and I charge this by pressing the button and doing it again, that'll flash once I've dialed it in. I'll go in and get my setting. Then I will dial to the preset number that it gives me, and I'm ready to take my photograph. And that's it. That's how to do a custom white balance.